recording. There's something that you are doing wrong. They are making you fat, diabetic, more prone to cancer, heart disease, autoimmune diseases, and neurological diseases. Do you know there's something that is so simple to make it right, but without these minor details, you're never making you chrono-synchronize. So let's learn more about chrono-nutrition and chronobiology to make your better health without having to change your diet and any other lifestyle habits. Just getting your biological clock according to the sun. What is chronobiology? It's the study of time in living beings. That is what you have to understand, that from cyanobacteria to mammals, even to plants, every living organism in the planet has a circadian clock. What is a circadian clock? It's actually a biological clock that is living inside of your brain and inside of every single of your cells in your whole body. It's already well established in science that chrono-synchronization is actually one of the main causes of all our modern diseases. So you have to understand how to synchronize your biological clock to the rotation of the sun. So first of all, we have to understand there is two kinds of clocks in our bodies. We have the master clock that we call the suprachiasmatic nucleus. There is a region in your brain, upper supra, higher than the chiasmatic nucleus. That means a little bit higher than the eyes. So this master clock stays in your brain and it has to be synchronized to the sun. So these master clocks coordinate these peripheral clocks. There are actually clocks inside of each one of our cells and organs and systems. So these master clocks, for example, coordinate the pancreas to know when to secrete insulin. What is the best time to secrete insulin? So when you're trying, for example, to eat at night because of your rising melatonin, the sleep hormone, that will impair insulin sensitivity and insulin secretion. Stay tuned until the end of the video to understand all the details. So how we synchronize this master clock? Pretty simple. We have photoreceptors. Actually, there's a little bit of debate about the photoreceptors, but we know one that's for sure is the melanopsins. It's a photoreceptors sensible primarily to blue light on our eyes that can capture the sunlight and understand what time of the day it is to send the message to the brain and synchronize our clocks. There are actually scientists that suggest that because other animals have it, but we don't know if humans actually have it, it's extraocular photoreceptors. That means we can also have photoreceptors on our skin, but it's still in debate, but still, we know by studies that if you even put a flashlight behind your knee when you are sleeping, you can impair the quality and the quantity of sleep just by exposing your skin to light. So it's really important to understand all the basics from chronobiology so you synchronize your clocks well and you can sleep well, because sleep is Mother Nature's grand restorative process. Sleep is actually when Mother Nature restore your functionality, repair your system, heal you. Understand a little bit of sleep hygiene so you don't damage your sleep and don't damage yourself and have a shorter life. Because I like a lot of Matthew Walker's speech about sleep. The shorter your sleep, the shorter your life. So sleeping less than 6 hours or less per day is correlated with an increase of all kinds of chronic diseases and a shorter life. So you don't want to sleep less. You want to have the highest quality and quantity of sleep as you can. So do you have trouble sleeping? Do you need to synchronize your circadian rhythm? Do you have your biological clock chrono-desynchronized? So if you need help, I can help you out as a clinical nutritionist. I attend patients online and in private, but it's in Brazil. But also, I have 10 books published. All of them are in Portuguese, besides Hygienic Fasting Nature Surgery, that is actually available on Amazon, on print on demand, or in Kindle version. Also, we have 6 online courses, but all in Portuguese. But we run retreats, always January and July, here in Brazil, so you can learn the science of health and how to apply natural hygiene to your daily life, so you have more health span and lifespan. You have more longevity, but more health into those later years. So these photoreceptors, primarily melanopsins, end up getting one of the clues from the environment. That is the light clue. But there are also other Zeitgebers, that means from the German word, givers of time. So what gives time to our circadian clock? It's actually several different kinds of inputs, like temperature. Our temperature should lower a little bit when we are about to sleep. Probably the temperature in the jungles where we came from were a little bit lower at night. So you don't want to make your bed temperature really high, but a little bit lower than the usual. Also, food intake. Food is one of the Zeitgebers. So when you eat late at night, your body still thinks it's day. Because you don't just eat late at night. You end up seeing electric lights late at night. That is one of the biggest mistakes, and I will teach you in the end of the video how to go about with that. Primarily light. When light hit our eyes, these melanopsin receptors understand that it's day and send to the brain, let's change. So melatonin, it's a contra-regulatory hormone from cortisol. So melatonin drops and cortisol rises in the beginning of the day. So when light hit your eyes around 6 a.m., melatonin starts to drop and cortisol starts to rise. So cortisol is the stress hormone. So you get like ready to work, ready to live. When the sun's starting to set, your brain starts to understand that it's time to go to sleep. So the lack of light sends the signal to the pineal gland to start to secreting the sleep hormone. That is actually also an anti-cancer hormone. We can also call the repairing hormone, because melatonin onset starts sleep. When you start to sleep, you start to repair the system, all the wear and tear that was caused during the day. So if you understand that chronobiology and also chrononutrition, because it's not just getting the time of the day right, but you also have to eat in the right time of the day. That most people don't understand that and end up eating late at night. So, for example, shift workers, according to the World Health Organization, they are actually more prone to cancer, heart disease, diabetes, like 3 times more heart disease, cancer, and diabetes just from living and working at night. So you have to understand that human beings are diurnal creatures, and we have to live during the day and sleep during the night. We have to respect this 12-hour cycle from light and the 12-hour cycle from night. But what we do as human beings, we turn on the lights, we turn on our cell phones, we turn on the TV, and end up chrono-desynchronizing our brains. Our brains doesn't know the difference from the sunlight to the electronic lights. So that causes imbalance in your bodies. imbalance with the clock genes. You have changing gene expression in metabolism. You have changes in microbiota. You have changes in hormones. When you damage your circadian rhythm, you end up damaging all systems in your body. Your glycemic controls go haywire. Your immune capacity to kill cancer cells go haywire. Because immunology also depends on chronobiology. There's actually scientific articles nowadays suggesting chrono-immunology, because both of them go hand in hand. You cannot separate the chronobiology from immunology. So if you have, you want to, a strong immune system to fight infections, to infectious diseases, but also to fight cancer, you need to chrono-synchronize. So now we know that chronobiology can impact your capacity to maintain a healthy weight. Yes, not sleeping enough and not having quality sleep changes a lot of hormones correlated with metabolism, like ghrelin, leptin. That means you feel more hunger, you feel less satiated, and you feel more stress. So more stress, you end up eating more junk food. So it's really important to understand chronobiology details to apply to your daily living if you want to be healthy and you want to have a longer, happy life. So that's why, for example, pilots and flight attendants end up having more susceptibility to chronic disease because they fly from different time zones every time. So their biological clocks have a really hard time to adapt to these changes from changing like maybe 8 hours in your biological time. So that makes you more prone to disease. So you have to respect your biological clock. When you see night light, your brain thinks it's midday when it's actually 10 p.m. So that causes a lot of biological imbalances. The last thing you have to understand is time-restricted feeding. The fasting during night is really important for maintaining homeostasis, for maintaining your health. So respect night. Understand that as long as you see light, you want to eat. And as long as you want to eat, you don't maintain an intermittent fasting of at least 14 hours a day. For me, at least, I maintain an 18-hour fasting per day. That works a lot better for me, for health-wise and work-wise. But you have to understand that you have to give your body a break, not just from digesting food, but from working. Your body needs to rest. It needs to accept the darkness. You're going to even feel better when you turn off the lights, when it's time to turn off the lights, or else your body, you continue to get more stress, more cortisol levels at night. It's not good. So please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button for notifications, and comment below, give it a thumbs up, and share with everybody that needs to know this message. If you like it, there's more. Click these videos to watch.